To create a new Pi workbook, choose File and then New. You get the dialog box we've seen before. This time though, we're going to choose PIW. And this, that stands for Pi workbook, by the way. And this is going to be where you specify the name of the workbook. That's typically the same as the name of the file. So for example, I'm going to call this My Pi Book 2. And that's the name of this. As you can see, it's labeled. You see the little asterisk there? Whenever you see an asterisk, it indicates that this is a record that hasn't been saved yet. It's kind of flagged as being dirty. It's somebody's touched it, but they haven't yet saved it to, you know, make sure they've saved their changes. So that's what the asterisk is. At this point, I can go ahead and save this. When you save it, as you can see, it's going to take the name of that document or that workbook that you first specified. There we go. Now, once you've done this, you can then go ahead and start adding new entries. We'll talk more about adding entries in just a minute. But it basically works like this. Choose File, New, and then ProcessBook Entry. There are five different types of entries you can add. Again, File, New, ProcessBook Entry. We're going to go into the detail about what all these different entries are just a little bit. As you can see, my example over here, I have something called My ProcessBook, in which I've got two displays or two pages. And I've got a display on one page. So consider coming up with some kind of a naming convention. Are you going to use, you know, this view, or are you going to use outline view? I like identifying this by page, but you could identify it by different function as you choose. If we look at our demo, you know, the ProcessBook demo looks like this. But I could easily go through and decide I want a different look and feel. One of the easier ways to do this is in outline view. I can just decide I'd like to demote some things, put everything on the same page. Actually, I can grab, let me grab entire groups of this. We'll demote all of this so that we do still have the right kind of hierarchy, but it's just all demoted to everything being on one page, for example. So I'll demote everything. Just demote this. And now what you'll notice is when you switch to book view, there should only be one page because that's the only level one that we see. So consider, you know, consider how you're going to do this. Yeah, here we go. Here's my book is essentially everything on one page at this point. Everything that we saw earlier. Actually, I spoke too soon to say it's all on one page. It's all in the workbook format or the book mode. To go to the rest of the things that don't fit on this one page, I have to use this little icon up here. So that flips through my workbook now. But see, what we're suggesting is that you give it some thought as to how you're going to organize all this. You can organize it in hierarchical fashion. You can choose that you'd like to use outline view. But whatever you choose, just give it some thought before you start building your displays so that you do have some kind of a naming convention in place and you've got some kind of an organization principle that's going to survive as you start adding new things and new units.